Hello, I'm Fabrice from eSHa, and in the previous video we showed you how to check your fish for worms. You can find the link in the description box below. Besides worms, various unicellular parasites can be found in the intestines of fish. In this video, we have a look at the five most common unicellular parasites found in fish feces. Hexamita can cause one of the most infamous fish diseases called hole-in-the-head disease. Be aware that these organisms are very small. At 100-fold magnification, you can only distinguish fast-moving organisms. Using 400-fold magnification, you can see the shape of the flagellates, which is oval and slightly elongated. You might ask yourself, how is it possible that they move this fast? To answer this question, we will use a microscope with phase contrast illumination. Hexamita and spironucleus are very similar and have 8 flagella. 2 flagella are found on one side of the cell and 6 on the other. These flagella enable the parasite to move very fast. You can also recognize these parasites with normal bright field illumination, as you can see here. Cryptobia can be confused with Hexamita at 100-fold magnification. To see the difference, you can use a magnification of 400. The Cryptobia cells are sharper at the ends and look similar to a bunch of moving mice. The main difference with Hexamita is that Cryptobia only possesses 2 flagella. Despite having 6 flagella less, Cryptobia can move as fast as Hexamita. Protopalina can be found in several fish species. We often find them inside discus fish. Their size is about 15 times larger than the previous flagellates. They are clearly visible at 100-fold magnification. Protopalina move very smoothly. They are oval in shape, which may remind you of a zeppelin. At higher magnifications, you can observe many cilia attached to their cell wall. They only have 1 flagellum at their tail. This is a comparably big unicellular parasite from the group of ciliophora. Nectotheras is clearly visible at 40 times magnification. These cells are also oval in shape and covered with cilia. At 100-fold magnification, you can see the triangular nucleus. Nectotheras can be easily recognized by this feature. Fish like discus, methanus and mylius are regularly infected with this parasite. Balancidium is rounder than Nectotheras and is half its size. Sometimes you can see the mouth. Here you can see it clearly. Unfortunately, fish can be infected with several types of parasites at the same time. Here we have a case of unicellular parasites and worms. In other videos, we will explain how to treat fish against the most common diseases. Do you want to learn more about microscopic fecal examination? Watch part 3 regarding non-parasitic microorganisms. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe if you like this video.